They were supposed to ease the pain of an 89-year-old woman in a nursing home. Hundreds of prescription painkillers.
But she never got them. And tonight, her daughter wants to know why.
And so do we. KMBC 9's Chris Katz has spent weeks poring over records, revealing a big problem that you can avoid.
What do you miss most about your mom?
Her love of life. She was always happy. Regardless of what the circumstances were.
Verna Goff was 89 when she died in May of last year. Because she suffered from Alzheimer's, her final days were spent here at the Garden Valley Manor and Rehab Center in the Northland. She also suffered from back pain, which is why doctors prescribed hydrocodone. 500 milligram tablets of hydrocodone.
We asked that they give her a pill in the morning and a pill in the afternoon.
And did that happen?
No.
But the pills were ordered. In the 12 months between September of 07 and September of 08, 930 hydrocodone tablets were paid for and delivered for Verna Goff. During that same time period, nursing records show she got just 123 tablets. But what happened to the rest? 807 tablets in all.
What happened to the other 800?
That's the question nobody can answer. Even a police investigation failed to answer it. An investigation where months of records were studied. Physician's orders, pharmacy records, even records showing what Medicare paid for. A nursing home official, while confirming the discrepancy, doesn't know what happened to all the pills either. And as hundreds of pills went missing, pharmacy reorder records were still being filed for even more hydrocodone tablets, sometimes on an ASAP basis.
Because I trusted that staff to take care of my mother, and they didn't.
But how often does something like this happen?
Unfortunately, this is extremely prevalent throughout the long-term care industry.
Wes Bledsoe is president and co-founder of A Perfect Cause, a nonprofit group focusing on problems in the long-term care industry nationwide. So can you keep this from happening to your family? The answer is yes. Bledsoe's best advice is the same as Janice Payton's advice. There are records you can ask for. Physician's orders, pharmacy records, and daily records of what's given, and do this once a month. Janice Payton is now wishing she had done this while her mother was still alive.
I want people to know it's so simple to avoid. All you have to do is ask.
Nursing home management declined an on-camera interview, but in a written response to our questions, the current administrator told me that staff members involved in Verna Goff's case no longer work at the facility and have not worked there in over 2 years' time. It should also be noted Garden Valley Manor and Rehab was operated by a different company and different management at the time of the Goff case. Right now at KMBC.com, we have all kinds of help if you have a loved one in care or are shopping for a nursing home. We have a nursing home checklist, your rights as a resident, even a way to compare nursing homes, all at KMBC.com. Click on As Seen on KMBC.
Now, Chris, I'm curious. You had made mention of a police investigation. What evolved out of that?
Well, a police investigation, the Platte County Prosecutor's Office, they looked into this case, but at the end could not determine what happened to those pills either. And it leaves the Verna Goff family with the very real possibility that those responsible for this may never be brought to justice.
Wow, good piece. All right, thank you.